Welcome to E.P.G. Paathshala. I am Jitu Mishra from Virasatehin Foundation. I am presenting to you for the next 30 minutes on architecture of Rajasthan. Let me begin with this quote. M.S. Naravane in his book, The Rajputs of Rajasthan, A Glimpses of Medieval Rajasthan, says, "The duality in the Rajasthan character was really astonishing. On the one hand, he was a grim warrior, forever ready to draw his sword, taking the cruelty, horror and pain of war in his stride. On the other hand, he was gentle, warm in his hospitality, a lover of music and dance, and kind to the women folk, even those of his enemy." From the quote what I presented, what we come to know about the dual character of a Rajput. At one hand, he is a warrior, known for his bravery. And the other hand, he is also compassionate, especially for the women folk. So he will go all his way to protect a woman, whether she is a Rajput or non-Rajput. So from there, we start the architecture of Rajasthan, which is the largest state in India, and it's known for its splendid architecture, whether it is a hill fort or it is a fort on the plain or it is a temple or it is a haveli or water architecture. So in every aspects of architecture, Rajasthan stands apart in the entire country for its unique diversity. And when we talk about the architecture of Rajasthan, its origin goes back to the time of the Indus Valley civilizations and later in the time of Buddhist period and also at the time of early historic period and later during the rule of Pratiharas, various clans of Rajputs. It evolved phase by phase, and you have also within the state of Rajasthan a diversity of architecture. So we are going to discuss about how origin and some of the basic aspects of Rajasthani architectures in different forms. And then we will also discuss about different Rajasthani forts and palace architecture and its traditional houses or haveli features of temple architecture, tomb architecture in Rajasthan. So Rajasthan is situated in the western part of India. It is the largest state in terms of area. The geography of Rajasthan is very, very distinctive from the rest of India. The Aravalli mountain range, which is the oldest mountain series in the subcontinent and also known for its very hard rock and stable landscape, passes through the state and divides into two parts. On the eastern side, you have the evergreen Mewar and eastern Rajasthan. On the western side, you have the desert of Thar and also Marwar region. And you have on both sides of Aravalli, you have distinctive architectural styles going back to the time of Indus Valley civilizations. They have evolved from time to time and expressed in a varieties of forms, which you would not find in any other states of India. The main inhabited Rajasthan, earlier it was known as Rajputna, is known mainly for its rich cultural diversity and traditions. It has a very colorful history, a land of warriors, a land of shepherds, a land of mercantile traders, a land of Jain merchants, a land of many, many interesting communities who have contributed immensely for making of Rajasthan for almost last 5,000 years. The traditional buildings of Rajasthan, which reflect their way of life. If you go to the desert region of Jaisalmer or Barmer, you see round huts with thatched roof made out of grass, which are built of locally available resources, and they are the best architectural practices aligned with the local climatic conditions. They keep the houses cool during summer and also warm in the winter. Then you have a range of havelis, and then in different cities, for example Jodhpur, you have houses mainly made out of mainly of blue colors. That is why it is also called Blue City. You also have in Bundi houses made of blue colors. Then if you go to Jaipur, you have houses mainly in the pink city area. You have havelis and houses mainly in of pink colors. So that is why it is also called pink city. And if you look at closely the architectural style, they blend uniquely the Rajput as well as the Mughal architectural style. Now we'll see how origin of Rajasthani architecture evolved. Around 6th century CE, Rajasthan architecture developed in and around the desert region of Rajasthan, mainly in the area such as Osia or in Kiradu, that is in Barmer district. Osia is in Jodhpur district, with an architectural style of temple which is called Maru Gurjar style. And over a period of time, these architecture got elaborated, and then you have some of the best haveli styles, haveli architectures, and you have also some of the best secular architecture in terms of forts. Now we'll come to the secular architectures. So Rajasthan is a chock-a-block of forts and palaces which are scattered all over the area, all over the state. Some of the most prominent are like the three hill forts of Jaipur, namely such as Amer Fort, then Nahargarh Fort, and then Jaigarh Fort. They are all located on the crest of the Aravali Mountains, and they offer a panoramic from there. You can have a panoramic view of the city. And among these forts, the first one is the Amer Fort. Then when we go to the next major fort in Rajasthan is located at Kumbhalgarh, which was the birthplace of Rana Pratap Singh. It is close to Udaipur. Kumbhalgarh also has the longest wall in India, going almost for 20 to 30 kilometers. And the wall is also, that is also considered the second longest wall after the Great Wall of China. It is located also in the Aravali. Then you have the fort of Chittorgarh, which is known for Rani Padmini and Mirabai, who were known for their bravery as well as also for their Mirabai's devotion for Lord Krishna. And Chittorgarh, it was a strong Hindu fort which was also one of the oldest, which also influenced the later fort architecture of the state. Then you have in Jodhpur, Mehrangarh Fort, which was built in the 15th century AD, and it is also one of the strong and one of the most beautifully designed forts, with a strong bastions and well protected. Inside you have a series of apartments, royal apartments, overlooking the city of Jodhpur, and each of the apartments, the royal apartments, is intricately designed with murals, with the glass work, and with stone carvings. Then you have fort at Jaisalmer, which is also called the Golden Fort because of its colored stone. Then you have also fort at Bundi, which was the capital of the Hadoti region. Bundi is located to the southeast of Rajasthan, nestled in the Aravali Mountains. You have also fort in Udaipur, which was the capital of the Sisodia Rajputs. It's also one of the major strongholds, Rajput forts of India. Then you have also fort at Bikaner. You have fort, besides these, you have forts, small forts located in almost every corner of the state. One of the interesting features of the forts of Rajasthan is that they are built on the city top, and they were not just fortifications or consisting of the royal palaces, but they were also at the same time major trading centers. There were temples built within the fort and just in the periphery of the fort. For example, the Golden Fort of Jaisalmer, which was ruled by the Jaisalmer Fort, for example, is a fort which is also called as the Golden Fort because of its stone which strike resembles with the gold gold was ruled by the Bhatti Rajputs, and it is also one of the only, it's only of its kind as a living fort. And you see beautiful Jain temples, you have beautiful havelis, and they are all inhabited by the present communities living there. So they are not just mere forts, the Rajput forts in Rajasthan. They were also at the same time having other settlements as well, and many of them are like, you know, the living examples. And also, if you go to the Amer Fort in Jaipur, maybe not in the fort itself, but surrounding the fort, there is a vibrant township which has temples, Jain terraces, then havelis, then bawdies. So all of them are there. So they are just they are not just mere forts, but they were also places for people, coexistence of people of all faiths and communities living together. Now, when we talk about fort, Mehrangarh Fort comes to our mind first, which was built by Maharaja Jodha in 1460 AD. The fort is located on a hilltop in the present day city of Jodhpur in Marwar region. It has many palaces, courtyards, temples and other structures built by various kings of Rathore rulers, Rathore clans. What you have in Mehrangarh Fort, what makes it interesting, it was actually called Mihiragarh, not Mehrangarh in the earlier time. Mihiragarh means, Mihir in Sanskrit is sun god or Surya. So since Jodhpur is a city where you have maximum sunlight because of its location in the Marwar Thar desert, so it is very hot and the sun god is very powerful. So that is why it is called Mihirgarh, the fort of the fortress of the sun god. And the Rathore clan also, they trace their lineage to the sun god, going back to the time of the Ramayana. So it was called Mihirgarh, and now it's the Mehrgarh is the corruption of Mihirgarh, and it is made out of very thick ramparts overlooking the city of Jodhpur. It has got a series of towering gateways, and inside you have beautifully designed, intricately carved havelis, which were the royal palaces meant for the Janana and also the Mardana. And one of these is called Phool Mahal, the other one is Shish Mahal. One of these is Shish Mahal, the other one is called Phool Mahal. And most of these palaces which you see within the Mehrangarh Fort are beautifully decorated with different kind of architectural styles, stone carving, stone art, and then paintings, the glass paintings, and all with different types of colors and all. Shish Mahal is one of the private rooms of the Rathore clan, the ruling clan, where you have beautiful mirror work on the ceilings as well as on the walls. And then you have glasses in the Shish Mahal have also been used for making of different deities such as Ganpati or Vishnu, which are shown beautifully made of glass on the walls of the Shish Mahal. The other major mahal located in Mehrangarh Fort is Phool Mahal. Phool Mahal was built by Rao Abhay Singh in the 18th century, and it actually appears as a golden palace because of its profusion of golden color used on its walls. And then you have also paintings and glass paintings Unlike the Tanjavur style of painting, here you have a very subtle colors used, and there are depictions of Ramayana, Mahabharata and local heroes, life of the local heroes. All of them have been beautifully decorated in different colors you see in the walls of Phool Mahal. Then you have also the ceiling is also reflects the Persian carpet style. So that is how Phool Mahal stands apart. You have also colorful glass. So that is how Phool Mahal stands apart when it comes to the palaces. It's one of the most beautifully designed palace. So many people try, many historians have tried to interpret that Mehrangarh fort was actually influenced by the fort of Gwalior. But many also historians to agree to the point that it has nothing to do with Gwalior fort, because it has its own unique features. Gwalior of course has its own unique features. Mehrangarh fort has its own unique feature. And Percy Brown, the scholar of the art historian of early 20th century, had interpreted that Mehrangarh fort cannot be compared with any fort of India, because it stands definitely high among all the forts of India because of its unique architecture and architectural styles. You have a Chamunda temple, which is the family deity of the Rathore family, Rathore rulers, also on the terrace of the fort. Now, when it comes to the fort of India, Amer Fort, which is located near Jaipur city, around 11 km from Jaipur, the capital of Rajasthan. It's also one of the jewels among the forts of India. It was ruled by the Kachavas or the Kushavas, or a Rajput clan built this fort, which is one of the earliest hill forts of Jaipur city. Kachavas had come from the region of Gwalior, where they had a remarkable presence in the earlier centuries. They came to Rajasthan and they settled down at Amergarh fort, where they had built a beautiful fort. And it was Raja Man Singh who executed grand projects within Amer fort early 7th century. He was one of the Navaratnas of Akbar and he was a trusted general. He first constructed the Man Mandir Palace, which was the oldest block of the fort. He also built the Mansagar Lake in 1610 CE by damming the Darbavati River for irrigation and recreations. So the Mansagar Lake is one of the most beautiful lakes which was built by Raja Man Singh, and located in the city of Jodhpur. And within the fort there is a palace called Jal Mahal, which looks spectacular even now, though it is not accessible because of its fragility it has to be restored. So it is not accessed by the common public, but it is one of the most beautiful places in Jaipur. And during the time of Raja Jai Singh I, Amer Fort reached to a new height. So at that time, Raja Jai Singh I, also known as Sawai Jai Singh, he was the founder of Jaipur city. So he built many of the palaces, including Aina Mahal, which is there in and other palaces. He was also a great planner, he was a great visionary king. So because of his vision, Jaipur could become the first planned city of India. Within the fort at Amer, he built a beautiful Charbagh garden, and also near the Diwane Khas, overlooking the Mauta lake. When it comes to the gardens of India, it was of course the Mughals who had brought in the concept of Charbagh garden in India. And since Rajputs had very close ties with Mughals, so it was also introduced in Rajasthan to a large extent. You have beautiful gardens in Rajasthan constructed by various Rajput rulers, and they are found in the city of Udaipur, in the city of Jaipur, in the city of Bundi. So they were found in in different cities where, you know, different clans of Rajputs had ruled. And the gardens were not just aesthetically soothing, they were also important because Rajasthan is a desert state and you have to have water bodies and fountains and trees bearing flowers and fruits to keep the climate cool and the places more enjoyable during summer seasons. So you see, like for example, at Deek Palace, which is on the northeastern part of Rajasthan, bordering Uttar Pradesh, that was the summer capital of Jat rulers from Bharatpur, where you have beautiful gardens designed in the architectural style of Mughal Charbagh Garden. You have also a Charbagh Garden in front of Chitrasala in Bundi Fort, which is also the hanging garden. And what we see in Bombay, Mumbai, having a hanging garden, actually the concept of hanging garden you see for the first time in Bundi Fort, which goes back to 17th century, 18th century. Then you have also beautiful gardens at Amer Fort and also Sahelyon Ki Badi in Udaipur, where you have also beautiful gardens. Now, when it comes to water in Rajasthan, it is of course an essential element of life. Without water, it cannot be thought of living. And Rajasthan being a desert state, it receives rainfall but during monsoons, but the soil structure of the desert state is such that, you know, it doesn't allow it to hold for a long time after the monsoon. So the water gets evaporated once the monsoon season is over. To tackle this problem, its ancient rulers, and not only rulers but also the noblemen and merchants, they built a varieties of water harvesting structures in different geographical regions within Rajasthan. Some of them are like, you know, step wells or jhalras, which are known, which are found in large number in the city of Jodhpur. Then there are talabs, wells, and a variety of other water harvesting structures throughout Rajasthan. You can see how beautiful talabs, like for example in Bundi, where you have a large number of talabs and step wells. It is actually known as the city of step wells because there are more than hundreds of step wells found in the city. Then you have in Jodhpur, you have large talabs, you have large baudis, and then you have in Jaipur, as we saw, the Mansagar is a very large lake. Then you have also lake step wells in Osia, you have step wells in other parts as well. And when it comes to Sekhawati regions, you have a large number of wells which are built again in the style of Mughal architecture. Now coming to the temple architecture of Rajasthan. Temple architecture, as we discussed in one of the, that was the earliest form of architectures we see in Rajasthan, going back to the time of 6th century BC. So there are three distinctive styles of temple architectures which we see in Rajasthan. One is called Mahagurjara, the other one is called Marugurjara, and the third one is called Mahamarugurjara. Among these, the Marugurja style is the earliest, which comprises of Garvagriha or Mula Prasada, Goda Mandapa or Mahamandapa, and a post like the Antarala of Nagar temples. There are a number of places in Rajasthan where you have such temples, but the two major centers are Osia and Kiradu. Osia is located in Jodhpur district, about 100 kilometers, 70 to 100 kilometers from the city, in near a desert dunes. It was also a major mercantile center. The Pratihara kings had made Osia as a flourishing trading town on the trade route connecting Gujarat, the ports of Gujarat and the North India. Though it was a inhospitable terrain because of sand dunes and desert, but it had become a major center of temple building, and the many of the mercantile communities, for example the Oswal community, the Vanya community and the Jain communities, they come from Osia. Then there is another place called Kiradu, which is located again on the desert sand dunes, very close to Barmer city in Thar desert towards Indo-Pak border, where you have some of the finest temples of Solanki style, bearing a range of artistic elements. Now, we have seen that how in Rajasthan, Rajput architecture flourished, where you have, which was actually a mixture of Mughal and Hindu structural designs. So some of the best fort or architectures in India and you find in Rajasthan, and that is how it's also a tourist state. A large number of tourists come to Rajasthan mainly to experience, to enjoy its architectures, and they reveal not only aesthetic but also harmony. There is a unique blend of Indo-Islamic style, like for example the miniature paintings of Rajasthan, which have which were heavily influenced by the Mughal miniatures, but there were also a core Hindu identity, because you have the essence of Hinduism when you look at the miniature paintings of Rajasthan. Besides depicting the court scenes or the hunting scenes or other things, there are also scenes of devotions of Radha Krishna's Rasas or scenes from the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. And today, the forts and palaces of Rajasthan, along with its temple and havelis, mark as a major center of tourism. So there is a note which describes in great detail about the architecture of Rajasthan of different styles, followed by a number of references which can be referred to for further understanding on the architecture of Rajasthan. And then there are also films links, there are also articles written by us which have been also provided in the references. So you can refer to these, and I hope this will help you to understand more about the architecture of Rajasthan. Thank you a lot for being patient to listen.